I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I believe that it is by God's divine appointment that a session like this becomes the opening session. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge the man of God, Pastor X, who God is using in this side of the world to transform lives. And I know that the prayers that have been going in this place will bring results.
Amen.
Amen. We also want to acknowledge the great apostle all the way from USA, who is here with his wife, mother of many, many Americans and many Africans. And we believe that there's still a lot in store to give birth to, which God has deposited in your life. I want to tell you, man of God, that you are welcome in this side of Africa, and may you be fruitful as we are here. Amen.
Amen.
I also greet Pastor Span's wife, Pastor Span, the glory to God, the great man of God, and many other people who are here, and Minister Nixon for hosting such kind of a very delicate event. Whenever this talks about money, you don't have a big audience. Amen.
Amen.
Why? Because money is a living thing. Money has got a soul. Money moves. That's why it's called currency, because it moves. It's like current. Glory to God. It is very spiritual when you talk about money. It actually offends many. It's like somebody has insulted you when people are not even focusing on you. So it goes to show that it's a living thing. Amen. But we are not here to talk about money, but we're talking about the kingdom. Hallelujah. Kingdom. Now, I will just read a scripture so that I don't begin to start talking and preaching. I'm a preacher myself. I'm not a banker, so I might touch here and there. But I know that at the end of the day, we'll all come back to the scripture. Now, in the book of Proverbs, I think it's Proverbs 6, verse 7, it says, be not deceived. Glory to God. Can you put it up there? It says, be not deceived. Whatsoever a man soweth, that will he reap. Amen. Now, God equates fruitfulness in sowing and reaping. Hallelujah. Whatsoever you sow, you will reap. That means he says, if you become fruitful, you shall eat the good of the land. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So as we gather in this place, we talk about sowing into something that will change lives, sowing into something that will move in the airwaves and touch people in Korea, touch people all over the world. But it all begins by people buying into the vision and saying, this vision here, although it might look small, we will know that what Nixon saw is bigger than where we are right now. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Proverbs 4 verse 18 says, the path of a just man is like a shining light that shines brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. Glory to God. Now the path of a just man keeps on shining. It keeps on shining. It keeps on shining. Many times, if you don't know where, let me give you an example. If you don't know where you are going, wherever you go looks like it. If you don't know where you're going to, wherever you're going looks like that's where I was going to. Until something tells you this is exactly where you are supposed to head to. Amen. Hallelujah. I believe that this vision of Elevate Africa Networks has been tested. The first month he started, second month I think he's been navigating until he begins to find out, okay, this is where I'm supposed to go to. And when a man has found a way where he's going to, he needs helpers by his side. I remember God talking to Moses, and then talking to Moses, first of all, says, Moses, be with the people. And when Moses was with the people, he did not quickly rush and be away from the people. He was with the people, and when people started growing, extremely efficient, and God says, God, Moses, move ahead of the people. Why did God ask Moses to move ahead of the people? He was asking Moses to move ahead of the people so that you will stop hearing what people are saying and only hear what God is saying. Glory to God. So when a vision gets to this level, you have to be very attentive to the voice of God. Because when you begin to hear men, they will come with many opinions until you lose focus where God sent you to. Amen. And I also believe that by now, structures are in order, that now we need divine helpers, kingdom finances. Amen. And that should be it's a very good prayer point. Amen. To pray for kingdom financials. Because not everybody is a kingdom financial. I mean, everybody is a Christian, is a believer, and everyone is about to come to church. But you see, you need to get people to rise up to another level. I'm glad that you mentioned your brother here, that he saw you, he did not look for any qualifications, but he just believed in your vision. Amen. And those are the kind of people that see things before other people see them. Amen. We need many believers to begin to see things in that manner. We were discussing there with the pastor X and the apostle that many times why the other religions beat us. And we always ask, but these Muslims, no, we are complaining. Muslims are taking all our schools. We've got prayer points. Father, stop them. You can pray until you run out of your hair. Nothing will happen. They will still go on there. The reason is they've got an agenda. They've got an agenda. Your prayers will not stop what they want to do. The Hindus, I've never seen Hindus going house by house knocking and telling people that Jesus Christ is Lord, or Hindu is Lord, or whoever their God is. I've never seen a crusade. I was talking about this. I've never seen a crusade of the Islam to get people into a crusade. We are the ones who are running everywhere, and we can't even reach the people. It's because we don't have an agenda. What is our agenda? Why are we Christians? Why do we come to church? What is our agenda? Now, when we get a vision like this, it is an agenda. We want to get the gospel into airwaves, into people's phones, into everywhere. That must be an agenda. And once you have an agenda like that, even if churches become full without us going extra mile, Saturday afternoon, we are supposed to go and relax. Now we are in the street trying to witness the village. The devil is a liar. We are not going to do that. Amen. We must have an agenda. We must have an agenda. Amen. We must have an agenda. Once we have an agenda, people of God, the work of God will be so easy. The work of God will be so easy. Why? Because we have an agenda. We will not spend much time frustrated when people are not coming and forcing people to come to church. No. People will come to church because they know these are visionaries. They know where they are going to. And we follow them because they know where they are going to. So I also like to encourage that as the days come by, as the speakers begin to speak, let them all not lose focus why we are here. We are here for a fund raising to fund Elevate African Networks so that we can move into new heights. Nixon has managed to get some divine help and favor from people in the media world who are there, who know exactly who can help them and advise them. Our job as believers is not to advise him how this station must go. There are already people who are in that area. I mean, there are editors in there, they know that area. What is needed is the money now. So let's have a focus on saying, if you put the money, the executive know exactly where to take this thing to. Amen. So, I don't know, maybe you might not see me again on the podium here. Let me just say, in case some of these people, you can say one mistake and you are never in the program. So, perhaps you have a microphone, just utilize it. You see, it takes partnership to get something moving. Sometimes it might not need your 100,000 rand. It might need your monthly 100 rand, which you are partnering with the station. And then when 100 people bring their 100 rand, we are going somewhere. Do you understand what I'm saying? We are going somewhere. We are going somewhere. So don't be intimidated by somebody who come in here and say, no, I'm going to give 100 million. Which we can clap hands. We can clap hands and stand up. So that by standing up, you'll be ashamed not to bring that money. But what I'm saying, we are here. If you begin to say, okay, fine, let's put some money from your heart, you know. Say, maybe I'm going to start with 100 grand. Or rather, I'll say, maybe 200 grand every month. Another 500 grand. It depends. But we don't want you to end up not having food because you end up saying, this thing of the gospel is not helping me. But let me tell you something. Once you partner with something of God, you will never run out of bread. Because the Bible says, whatsoever, do not be deceived. Whatsoever you sow, that is also reap. So God equates fruitfulness with sowing and reaping. God bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah.